Hello everyone. Now before starting this chapter, let me ask you something. What all things crosses your mind when I say the word magnet? Now if you ask me the same thing, that what all things crosses my mind, I used to think about the two magnets whom I used to play with as a child. Now I was very much amazed by their remarkable property that when I used to bring them closer to each other, they reacted in a very different manner. They sometimes tried to come closer to each other and sometimes they tried to go away from each other. So I was very much amazed that why they act in this way. Sometimes they try to come near to each other and sometimes they try to go away from each other. Now if you try to find for the magnets around you, you'll find them everywhere. You'll find them on the doors of the refrigerators. They are used to stick the doors to the surface of the refrigerator. You'll find them in your music amplifiers, in your musical speakers. And if you know about Captain Jack Sparrow, he used his magical compass to navigate wherever he wanted to go. Now we don't have such a magical compass, but we do have a magnetic compass with us. This points always in north-south direction. And sailors do use this magnetic compass since a long time. Now, have you ever wondered that why do magnets behave in such a strange manner? When we bring two magnets closer to each other, then they either try to move away from each other or they try to come near to each other. Why do that magnetic compass always points in north-south direction? There must be some reason for this, right? In this video, we'll try to understand the reason behind these properties of the magnet. Magnets have been a source of curiosity for people of all ages since a very long time. The word magnet is being derived from the magnetite ore, which shows the properties of a magnet when it is in its raw state. The magnetite ore is an ore of iron. Now, we had seen that when we bring two magnets closer, they either attract or repel each other. So let's try to find out the reason behind it. Now, this is explained by the idea of magnetic field, which says that every magnet is linked with an invisible field, or you can say a ghost type field. Now, when a second magnet is brought near the magnetic field of the first magnet, then the magnetic field of the first magnet interacts with the magnetic field of the second magnet and then they behave in that way. They either attract or they either repel each other. Now, when do they attract each other? When the magnetic fields are in the same direction, then they try to attract each other. This happens when North Pole and South Pole comes near to each other. Then they will attract each other. Now, when the magnetic field are in opposite directions, then they try to repel each other or the magnets try to move away from each other. So this happens when same poles are brought closer. That means then north and north are brought closer or south and south are brought closer. So they'll repel each other. Now, how to find the direction of magnetic field? The direction of magnetic field due to any magnet is found by placing compass at different points of the magnet. So we'll get the direction of magnetic field by using this compass. The direction of this compass shows the direction of magnetic field at that point. Now, magnetic field is an invisible field. So to understand it better and to know the properties of magnetic field in a better way, we represent magnetic field by using magnetic field lines. Now, these magnetic field lines in a way describes the very nature of magnetic field. Its number signifies the strength of magnetic field. We'll say that if the magnetic field lines are denser at a point, then the strength of magnetic field at that point is more. And if the magnetic field lines are lesser in number at a particular point, then the strength of magnetic field is less at that point. The direction of magnetic field lines shows the direction of magnetic field at that particular point. So we were talking about the bar magnet, and we had seen some lines made around it when we were studying the magnetic field. So these lines were nothing but the magnetic field lines. The magnet which we are talking from the starting is known as the bar magnet. Now the bar magnet has two poles in it. One is the north pole and the other one is the south pole. So if we talk about the magnetic field lines or the magnetic field of this bar magnet, they always emerge from the north direction or the north pole to and they go to the south pole. So if we talk about the magnetic field lines of this bar magnet, they will be like they'll emerge from the north pole and they will end on the south pole. So the magnetic field lines of a bar magnet are something like this. Now if you remember, we had talked about the magnetic compass in the starting of this video. Now magnetic compass is used in navigation purposes as it always points in north-south direction. Now let's suppose that I keep the magnetic compass here, so it'll point in north-south direction. If I try to move it, then also it will point in the north-south direction. If I try to rotate it, then also its north-south direction remains the same. So why is it so? What is the reason behind this? Now magnetic compass has a small bar magnet inside it. So we can say that some magnetic field is interacting with the magnetic field of this small bar magnet and always trying to rotate it in the north-south direction. Now this magnetic field is present all over the earth and this is trying to rotate it always in north-south direction. So scientists found out that this particular field that was turning the magnetic compass in north-south direction is the magnetic field of the earth, and it is present at all the places of the earth. So this was as if we had taken a huge magnet and put it at the center of the earth, and it was placed in such a way that the north pole points in the south direction and its south pole points in the north direction. So when a bar magnet is kept, then it gets attracted towards the south pole and north pole. The north gets attracted towards the south pole and the south gets attracted towards the north pole. So it always points in the north and south direction. Now the reason for this magnetic field of the earth is due to some activity that is going in the core of the earth. Now it is said that some molten metal is circulating in the core of the earth in such a way that it produces the magnetic field in this way. So the magnetic field of the earth can be represented as the magnetic field lines emerge out from the south pole as magnetic north is placed at the south pole, and they enter into the north pole of the earth as south pole of the magnet is placed at the north pole of the earth. So sailors use this earth magnetism to sail around the world, and they use the magnetic compass to know the direction of the earth.